Welcome everyone to another unboxing video. Kyle here as usual. Got my buddy Lemmy back again after his appearance on the Entrance Great retrospective video where he single-handedly destroyed Bill Goldberg. He is back again for another video just to hang out. We'll see how long he lasts. But today we're going to unbox something that I was not sure how I wanted to do, but it looks like we'll unbox the whole thing at once. It's the new Marvel Legends Black Widow movie wave from Marvel Legends. Well, I would be lying if I said that this wave really excited me as much as some of the upcoming waves like Age of Apocalypse and some of the fan channel exclusives that are coming out. This one didn't have all the bells and whistles, and I'm not a huge Black Widow fan. However, the movie looks okay from the trailers I've seen, and I believe that actually the movie has been delayed, so I don't know how that'll affect some of these toys. These have been hitting Walmart and Amazon. I'll have some Amazon links in the description if you guys want to check out what they look like or what they cost at the store, Amazon store. But we'll see what happens with these. Will these be pulled? Will they have second and third waves of these coming to the stores? I'm not sure with the movie being delayed. They may just hedge their bets and save some product, or they'll let these go out, have a huge delay, and then the wave two will come out when the movie does. A lot of unanswered questions about those, but that's not for me. I'm here to unbox and review these figures. So let's start it off with one of the ones I'm the most excited about is the Red Guardian. Red Guardian's kind of the Soviet version of Captain America in a way. I was a big fan of him in the comic books back in back when I was a kid. Very interesting figure. You can see it right here. The old Red Guardian. This is the Crimson Dynamo Wave, as a lot of you probably know. The Build-A-Figure. That's one thing I do love about Marvel Legends, is the Build-A-Figure aspect. Big fan of that. I think that's the way to go. I wish more lines would do that. It makes you, if you're on the fence about one or two characters, it makes you pick those ones up because you needed to collect that other character. You can also, if you're not involved and don't want the Build-A-Figure, you can flip those pieces pretty easily online, make some of your money back. Just a lot of ways. I think it's a good thing for the collector community as a whole. I wish WWE would do that more. Hopefully the upcoming G.I. Joe Black Series inspired classified series will be that way. Star Wars, I wish they would do that. But here we are with Red Guardian. Like I said, I was excited about him. My only gripe is, and maybe it'll be the future waves, they should have had an alternate head, or this should have came with a mask. You want a masked version. I get you also want an unmasked, but they should have came together in the wave. Something tells me we'll see this exact same figure with that hooded head down the line somewhere to get just more money from us. But we'll read the backs here. Alexei Shostakov is a super soldier and spy who has lived a lifetime of triumph during the Cold War. So let's open this guy up. Like I said, I was excited about this one. The Build-A-Figure Crimson Dynamo, that's not how I remember Crimson Dynamo looking back in the day. See ya. So I'm a little disappointed on that, I guess you would. There's the piece, left arm, Crimson Dynamo. We'll build him. We'll get him built before the day is over. See you later. See you later. All right, he's got his shield. Very, like I said, the Soviet version of Captain America in many, many ways is the Red Guardian. Here's his shield, his Soviet shield, the back. There it is. You know, Marvel Legends does get a lot of use out of some of these molds. I believe this is the same mold as Captain America with different head. Paint amps, paint applications look to be pretty good. A little bit of ear, a little hair black on the ears. But for the most part, very good. I do like this figure. I would have liked it with the alternate head, as I said, but I think this is one, especially I had not seen the movie yet. He is a main character in it, so this will be one that you would have to have, and I'm glad they made it. We'll see if he, oh yeah, fits right in the ringside collectible stand. You know, not all of them do. Some of them do, some of them don't, but this one definitely does. So that is the Red Guardian. All right, next up, we got the Black Widow, Scarlett Johansson version from the movie. A couple unboxings ago, I did the deluxe Scarlett Johansson figure from the movie with all the, you know, crazy smoke effects on the guns. the nice explosion scenes in the stand. This is the regular edition release in the black uniform. So that prior deluxe one was in the white uniform. And this is the black. I don't know how many Black Widow figures I need. That's one thing that kind of drives me nuts is I'm not a huge Black Widow fan, but boy, you know, there's been three or four prior to this. Now you got three or four with the Walmart Target Deluxe Edition. This one, I'm sure Series 2 will have another one. That's a whole lot of Black Widow figures to have, but you know, she will be a she is a popular character. Will probably get even more popular after having her own movie here shortly. Natasha Romanoff reunites with a group of spies from her past to stop a lethal force. So that's the bio card on the back. See you later. Show the back packaging here. Instructions, like I've said before, I don't get instructions. We don't need them, especially for something like this. There is the back graphics of the card. Boy, you can barely see that. Hopefully a little logo. Let's get the accessories. This looks to be the left boot of the Crimson Dynamo. We will build him at the end and see how cool he is. A lot of accessories. Let's see. One, two. Got an extra pair of fists. She's got two open hands to hold her guns. And then she comes with two fists as well. Nice and taped in there. We really appreciate the tape. If you don't have tape on these hands and stuff, they would just fall loose in the package, and it's never a good look. It also takes a little bit more work on the unboxing. Get all that tape off. There it is. So you got two fists. I don't know what these are. I'm not totally sure if these are just like nightstick type deals or what they are, but there's two of them. And obviously her two handguns. Get her out of the package. See you later. Very similar, if not the exact same head scan from that deluxe edition. Typical Marvel movements. Very stiff, but I prefer the figures really stiff out of the package. There's nothing worse than getting loose joints right out of the package, that is for sure. I got a holster on the sides, on both sides to hold both guns, which is nice. Put those in there maybe. Boy, tough to get in. This one's a little... Well, she's going to hold this gun because she obviously doesn't want it in her holster, so she'll hold it for all of us. I get these little guns, but boy, I hate the way they look. They're so small in the hand. Look at that. Just tiny. Here's the figure. There it is. Red hair. A good likeness, better than some of the Infinity War and previous ones. They have improved her head scan and stuff, which is to be expected with their own movie. You got to have really good figures, hopefully, to go along with it. See how these ankle joints. Ankle joints are better than the Target exclusive white one I had. If you guys remember back, one of the ankles was a mess. Couldn't even step on it. We'll see if a ringside stand fits here. I'm going to say no, but we'll see. Oh, fits like a charm. I'm hopeful that they've switched to all foots and everything being able to fit in these peg holes. Marvel Legend figures are very difficult to stand. I really do like a stand for my figures. So I'm very happy that worked out there for her. That's a good one. Like I said, one of the ones I was least excited about in the wave. But I understand it's her movie. You gotta have her. I mean, it makes total sense. We'll start a little Rogues Gallery here. Now here's one I was really excited about when I heard they were making it, but then looking at the package, I'm not totally sure, and that's Crossbones. There's the package there. You know, very toyetic skull type paint. Look at that cool picture on the side. And there's the back. A bit of a glare. This white packaging's tough to pick up with the camera. Crossbones makes it his mission to take out Captain America, no matter the loss of life at stake. So great to have a Captain America villain. We've had Crossbones in the past. I never got it. I got the old school one back in the 90s, but I haven't got any of the more recent year Toy Biz ones. But always a cool character, very toyetic. However, we'll get to it here, but get all this. Got a little bit different background. Gonna be hard to see, but it's got all the Avenger logos. I don't know if you can kind of see that in there. Yeah, it's very hard to see, but see it. Here it is. Another hand, another arm for Crimson Dynamo. Oh, Lemmy's taking a nap. He's out like a light. Lemmy, did we wake you? Just checking in. What are your thoughts on the set? Can you chime in? He's got to get a big nap in. We got a big long walk later today, so he's gonna conserve some energy. Lots of guns with crossbones. Get that out there. 2, 3. There it is. See you later. Now, this figure is a disappointment. I hate to say it because I was so excited for this one, but he's got the super giraffe neck syndrome. Big time giraffe neck syndrome. Very disappointing. I hate you can see the hinge. You can see the hinge in his neck very easily. You got it down a little bit, but definitely giraffe syndrome on him, unfortunately. It really takes away from the figure for me. It just doesn't look right. He needs to be a little bit more beefy, I think, up top. And we've got to be able to hide that neck joint better. It's just way too giraffe necky. Luckily, the paint apps on this one are very good. I don't see any major marks on his face. It's tough when you're doing the white, black, you know, skull face paint not to bleed over some of that. But yeah, just very disappointing to me. I do like these double barrel shotguns that he's got going on. Definitely going to use those in his hand. If they fit in his hand. Oh my. They take some work getting in there. But all in all, he's got two holsters on the sides to hold these two white guns. Just not feeling this one, unfortunately. And like I said, this one and the Red Guardian were probably the two I was looking forward to with Winter Soldier as well. Should have been one of the jewels of the set, unfortunately, as of right now. Maybe it'll grow on me. I strongly feel it probably will not grow on me. Just kind of unfortunate. Very cool opportunity for a cool figure. Just not making the grade. Right, Lem? Yeah. Unfortunately. But that is Crossbones. Does fit nicely on the stand, so we're 3 for 3 on fitting on stands, which I love. Need more of that, like I say. Next up, here's one. Like I said, I'm not a huge Black Widow person. I'm not deep into the Black Widow history. Yelena Belova, I believe it's her sister from, and I just know that from the trailers, unfortunately. A product of the Red Room's ruthless training program, Yelena Belova is a fiery assassin. Not familiar with her at all. I'm not going to lie and say I have any kind of memories of her. This is probably my least favorite in the set, least anticipated. Basically, you have to get her to complete the Crimson Dynamo. There it is. It's a lot of good pieces here. A little front piece, I believe shoulder piece, another shoulder piece, and then the chest, the big chest for the Crimson Dynamo. There's that. See, similar Avengers. You know, the small gun, it's a thing with these Black Widow villains. They got all these, or villains, the Black Widow good guys here. They got the very, very small guns. There you go. We've got two hands on this one, so you got open and closed fists. Difficult to get out there. See you later. Yeah, this one, it is what it is. Like I said, I'm not familiar with the character. She does have a little giraffe neck, but nowhere near as bad as Crossbones. I don't know. This one's not the most exciting for me. Hit me up in the comments. Tell me about her history and what I need to know about her and why I should care about her, if that is a thing or not. Basically, to me, this is a way to get the Crimson Dynamo. And one of these figures where majority of people might not buy it, but they buy it to complete the figure. So I have a feeling this one's not going to fit. Nope. So we will not fit on a stand with her. The peg holes are way too small on this figure. And she's got a cool braid action going on in the back of her hair. You can kind of see that a little. But Yeah, not my favorite figure in the set, but a must-have if you want to complete the Build-A-Figure. You got to have things like this. So, a lot more pieces. We're adding to the collection. We're going to get this thing built by the end. All right, moving on to another one. Now, this is one I've heard over the years and back in the day. Let's see. We'll read it here. Marvel Spy Master. An undercover operative skilled in sabotage, Spymaster possesses superb fighting capabilities. For some reason, as a kid, I remembered him in a match with Iron Man, maybe back in the day. I'm not sure if that's his primary opponent. A very big reuse of figure parts on this one. This is nothing new. This is basically a repaint of a lot of other figures we've had over the years, of like the Blizzards of the World and Eel and some of that. So it's a little bit of a cheap out, but you got to have some of these minor characters in the line. They can't just be Captain America and Iron Man every time. You need to build out that universe, and this is what this does. Like I said, always great putting the Build-A-Figure piece in there, making people buy it. So that's Spymaster. The blue and the yellow is a cool look. Comes with the leg of the Crimson Dynamo. There's the back. The other side. Paint apps look to be really good. I don't see any issues with this one, but we'll see. As soon as we get a little closer. Goodbye. Goodbye. Making a mess here. I believe the exact same gun that came with Crossbones, except this one is in red. The other ones were in a grayish white. There's the leg to the Crimson Dynamo. Bye. Yeah, very reused mold. They've used this many a times, but it works. It definitely works with this figure. It's okay. I don't know if he's going to be flying off the shelves. Definitely not a major villain like a Doctor Doom or anything like that. He's not going to be in the Black Widow movie. It's just a way for them to extend the line out and get some of these people. But for what it is, it's an all right figure. Yeah, I don't totally dislike it. I do like it better than Crossbones. Looks like the feet. Yeah, barely. It's a little bit of a big hole, but it will fit. So there it is, the Spy Hunter. Look at that. Looking good. All right, we're almost ready to build the Dynamo. We're only missing one piece, but we still got two more figures in the set. It's a big set. The Taskmaster. Now, this is a villain let's read the back. Taskmaster is armed with the ability to mimic an enemy's every single move. Pretty cool concept there, where he can copy everybody's moves and use them against them. He can learn from it. I believe he's turned good guy, turned bad guy. I think I know him more as being a Deadpool villain, but I know he gets around the whole Marvel universe. Obviously, he's going to be the lead bad guy in the Black Widow movie, so I'm glad they put him in there. For what I've seen of cases and pallet shippers, he is the one they have the most of, so I think they're shipping him 2 per case compared to some of these other ones. I don't know if that's good or bad. He's very toyetic, that is for sure. But, you know, people will want the main villain from the movie, you'd have to think, so I think that's the decision they made there. But there he is, the Taskmaster. A little different than his normal look I'm used to and his prior Marvel Legends figures. This is more of the Marvel movie. Lemmy, where are you going? You're out like a light, buddy. What do you think? You like this one? I don't know. Lemmy's Lemmy. It's a wild card. You never know what you're going to get with that little guy. Well, get this open here, hopefully. There it is. Ooh. See ya. A lot of accessories with Taskmaster. We got 2 extra sets of hands. We got his bow and arrow, we got a shield, and we got a big sword. So very cool to have that many pieces of accessories. But you know, the reason that is, he doesn't come with a Build-A-Figure part, so they can put a little bit more in there. Get all these hands out of here, and bow and arrow, and the crossbow, and you name it. Yeah, I do really like the gray, the blue, and the orange. It really works. It all goes together, flows. Paint apps are awesome on this figure. Yeah, this is a nice one. This is a must-have. A must-have in the line. The Taskmaster. See there? I mean, the colors really go together. You know, it's a nice different color concept that you don't see. He's got the ab crunch, all the typical Marvel points of articulation. You got the hood, the head. Yeah, very good. Comes with the shield. It's got, let's see here. So we put that on him. There it is. Fits like a glove. Very cool shield on him. There it is. The Taskmaster. A must have. I'm glad it's 2 per case. I think a lot of people will want this one. It might not be the easiest to get. Let's see if he fits. Oh yeah, fits on the stands. These are Ringside Collectibles stands. I think I mentioned that earlier. You can get these at ringsidecollectibles.com. Very, very cheap most of the time. You wait for some deals and some sales. There it is. The old Taskmaster. Very cool accessories. I will use all of them. He's got the crazy claw hands that usually are with the Spider-Man villains, kind of like Venom and Carnage and stuff like that. So kind of interesting they put that many hands with him. I would have maybe liked a gun or something, but beggars can't be choosers. So there he is, the Taskmaster. We'll put him right up front here with the group. That leaves us only one left. And this one I'm pretty excited for too. Like I said, Crossbones I was really looking forward to, Taskmaster I was looking forward to, and Red Guardian I was looking forward to. But this one is the Winter Soldier, and I never picked up the other Winter Soldiers back in the day. I was not a huge, huge Marvel Legends fan at the time when the original Winter Soldier figures were coming out, you know, 4 or 5 years ago. I was more of a pick and choose type guy, and I didn't really want to go back. Maybe I will someday and get some of those, but we'll see. But I think this one is plenty good for now. Winter Soldier there. Comes with a Crimson Dynamo head. The side, Bucky Barnes, as we all know, is the Winter Soldier. Read the back here. Winter Soldier is a fierce combatant and an asset in battle, no matter which team he fights for. You know, kind of a tweener, goes back and forth between good and bad. I'm very happy they made a new one, like I said, for obvious reasons, because I did not have Winter Soldier in my collection. And he is kind of a must-have villain, good guy, whatever he is this time. Gun, two guns. Like I said, the Crimson Dynamo head. There it is, like so. Ooh, there it is. Now I do like this one too, and I think first impressions, this is the best figure in the set. Very G.I. Joe-esque. I would assume we'll see a lot of this body mold for some of the G.I. Joe classified series we'll be getting the next year plus. We've got the Captain America type tattoo there on his arm. First glance, it looks like his bottom half is the exact same as the Black Panther Wave Eric Killmonger figure. Very similar to that. A little loose on the ab crunch, not terrible. He's got a gun in his holster. Very detailed figure. I do like this one. I think this is... I would look to see some of these weapons also in the G.I. Joe line in the future. You know, Hasbro, they're smart. They make, you know, Power Rangers, Marvel, G.I. Joe, Star Wars. They can reuse a lot of body parts. They can use weapons and so forth. So, good on them. Gets a little bit more variety in the line. Oh, yeah. Fits like a charm on the stand. Yeah, this is a must-have. And this is the hardest figure in the Wave. I found the Wave twice. Both times Winter Soldier was missing. Luckily, I had a buddy that came across it, picked it up for me, saved the day. But that is the Winter Soldier. Very, very, very cool figure. Let's get over here to the Crimson Dynamo. We'll see if I can put this together. I was never the best with Legos, but I think we can put this guy together. So here's the body. We'll grab an arm here, stick an arm in. This is a lot. Reminds me of the Captain Marvel Legends movie Wave with the Kree robot deal. A very similar, almost a repaint of that, I believe. Everything hopefully will fit. Every once in a while, these pieces will not go together on some of these. You got to take a hair dryer and gently give it a little bit of massage with that hair dryer to get everything together. Yeah, because sometimes the legs, they get a little tight, won't pop in. There we go. Got it. Let's see, moving them around. Yeah, I do love the Build-A-Figure. I love it when they're big, hulking figures. There's nothing worse than like the Hitmonkey Build-A-Figure, if people remember way back to that. I mean, it's a little figure about that big. Just seems like a waste of a Build-A-Figure to me. Let's see, where does this go? This is the back. We're learning together. It's his back little backpack deal there. We're getting there. We're coming together. I always save the head for last. Clipping in his shoulder, big shoulder pads, big hulking shoulder pads. Let me see, did I get that backwards? I very well could have. We're flying by the seat of our pants here, guys. Yep, I was backwards, that'll do it. We're almost there. There it is. All right. The last piece will be the head. And that'll be all she wrote. And we got the Crimson Dynamo. Like I said, not Crimson Dynamo, I remember to be smaller back in the comic books. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this is a new interpretation. Maybe he's changed in the comic books lately. But this one seems awfully big to me. But there he is. That is a big hulking figure. Very, very big. But like I said, for the Build-A-Figures, I like the big hulking figures. They work. That's what the fans want. I'm sure you guys out there, tell me if I'm wrong, but I want big figures. I don't want like Nebula from the Guardians of the Galaxy series. It's just a regular small figure. It just seems like a cheap out to me. Well, there you have it. That's the Black Widow wave of Marvel Legends. More unboxings to come. I have the Gamerverse Avengers lineup that I'll do an unboxing video for. Plenty more unboxings of all different kinds of things. Star Wars, wrestling, you name it, coming soon. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, please subscribe, please tell your friends. And until next time, this has been Kyle. Lemmy, can you wake up from your nap and say bye to the people? Goodbye, says my buddy Lemmy, the Corgi Poo. And until next time, see you later.